okay, family, I'm off to the next project. So I had planted some of my seedlings inside for the straw bale garden. And being that I already sold the seeds, I forgot that I had these in the house, and I brought them outside to try to overwinter them. Harden them off. And they fought through the weather and everything with the extreme heat. So these are actually some type of tomatoes. I'm not sure exactly what tomatoes these are, but I do know they are tomatoes. And y'all know I don't never remember. I forget all my tags and everything. So these buckets was already filled up with some soil, so I'm just gonna add some worm castings in there. And there was a method that I did wanna try. I should run in the house and do it. I wanted to try that egg method. Y'all heard about the egg method when it comes to tomatoes? You put an egg in there. Y'all heard about that? So let me get this one in here. And it's supposed to do wonders for your tomatoes. And I'm gonna bury her all the way down in there. All the way up. And I might even come back in here and sow some more seeds. And I think that's exactly what I'm gonna do, because I like to plant the seedlings and then throw in seeds next to it so I can have that continuous harvest. And this one actually is two. I'm gonna put two of my seed starts that I started in the house. And this one again, this is some type of tomato. Don't know what tomato it is, but I know it's a tomato. Hopefully she'll be okay. I'm sure she will. She got some good nutrients down there. And again, I'm burying her all the way down. This one is a little bit more established. And I'm going to pinch off this leaf right here, which would have been a stem, and get her all the way down there as well. And get some of this food down there. And get her all the way down there. I'm going to bury her all the way up as well. Let's see. Hopefully it gets some of that little lagginess out of there. And I think she'll be fine. I gotta remember to come back in and water them. I'm gonna water everything in a little bit. And then I'm gonna put two seeds in there. I might even put I might put some Tiny Tims in there. That's probably what I'll do. Okay, so that one is done. That task is done. Move my things over here. And I'm just gonna continue over here to this raised bed, which has the potatoes. And I did not bring you guys an update on this. I apologize for that. But I noticed a few weeks ago, this raised bed looked like a centipede hit the middle of it, meaning that all the potato vines just went this way, like that, and it was this big old hole in the middle. So, not thinking, because I really didn't think it was going to be time to harvest these, no time soon, but evidently, it is time to harvest these. So, let's get to harvesting some potatoes, y'all. And I'm going to turn you guys around. So y'all can see what's happening over here, and I'll probably work over in that angle. Show y'all. And this is another one of my buckets that I have to get filled up with something. My beef buckets. I love these buckets, y'all. Y'all need to get y'all some of those buckets. They easy to move around. Guys, over this way. All right, y'all see what's going on over here. So what I did do is I got my son to get out here and cut all the vines back. So that made it a little bit more easier for me to start digging. All right, you guys. So, let me get y'all angled a little better. All right, you guys, y'all remember when I planted this raised bed, right? I was just throwing them anywhere, right? So, being that my son, he pruned it back, it actually made it a lot easier for me to get in here. All right, you guys. We got potatoes. I'm gonna just sit them right there so y'all can see them as I pull. Guys, got some cute little potatoes in here. Whoa, all right, you guys, I'm getting real excited over here. Now, I've heard people say they let their potatoes stay in and they just harvest them as they need them. Ooh. Oh my goodness, y'all. The purple ones, y'all. They're grubs. Come over here. Okay, you guys, I'm on this, and I should have started over here, y'all. Okay, I'm just gonna toss them on over there. Oh my word. Okay. I might even try to throw these right back in here, y'all. Little babies. So I'm gonna keep those over there. Oh, here's another one. Thank you. while. This has a really healthy root, and I think I'm gonna throw this right back in there. See what this one got, y'all. Okay. Not bad. That's why I think, you guys, I'm definitely going to do an earth bed. I haven't got to it yet, and I think that's what I'm gonna do with the earth bed when I do the tilling out there. I think I'm gonna plant all my potatoes out there so that I can get a larger yield. Even though this is not bad for a first time in the raised bed. Let's see what this one has. Oh wow. She probably could have stayed in a little longer. But that's okay. Because I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably put this in some water. And I'm going to come through here and clean this bed up some. And I'm going to sit her right here. And I'm going to clean the bed up some. Get some of the straw out of here. Oh, damn grubs. Hey y'all, I'm gonna put that one over here. Sit down for a minute. Oh, my potatoes! Oh my goodness. Okay, so the stems over there that I need to pull to see what's on those. Need to make something to use all these little tiny potatoes. Ah, this is a nice one. Look at that, y'all. Pretty red. Red potatoes, I don't know if y'all know it. I learned this from my grandmother and my Aunt Mady. She taught me that. Oh shoot, look at that, y'all. Red, some purple. Okay, let me get all these, and then I'm going to just dig my hands all up in here. Ooh, there's still some stems here, so there's something underneath those. That is not bad for a first-time harvest of red and, what is these, finger tomatoes and purple. Potatoes. Okay, so back to what I was saying. My grandma, may she rest in power to it. And my Aunt Mady taught me that the best potatoes for potato salad is red potatoes, you guys. Red potatoes. You know why? They don't create as much water as the white potatoes. And they are much creamier. Y'all better stop playing. Y'all better make your potato salad with red potatoes. I'm telling y'all, y'all gonna love it. What? Here's another stem, y'all. And I got a few more on that side that I gotta get to. Purple. Yank this bad boy. What the world? What? Y'all see that? Hold on, y'all. Let me get these up. I wasn't expecting these to grow so fast. So when I did see the dieback on them, I was like, no, something is going on with them. Because I think I sold these maybe a month ago. Maybe a month. So I really wasn't expecting to harvest this soon. Then I said, you know what? It probably is time to harvest. These ain't sweet potatoes, you know? See, that's why I want to dig. I just want to dig in here. Let's see. Yep, see your hard look. Oh my goodness. I really was not expecting this much potato. I gotta get my okay. I need to get my weigher, my scale that I use for my soap making. And I need to definitely bring y'all some footage on that, because I'm like Uncle Led. I do so much stuff that I really don't have time to do videos on everything. But I do make soap and my own products for my hairdressing needs for my clients. And when I started to do my own products, I got into the soaping part of it. And I make shampoo bars, I make body soap, I make hair pomade and hair oils, and I sell everything in my salon and my clients. So I definitely need to bring y'all some footage on that. So when I get in the house, I'm gonna get my scale out. And I'm going to weigh my potatoes, darn it. Shoot. Okay, so that's that one that has a good root. It's a couple of them that has really good roots on there. The purple, and it looks like a fingerling potato. And over here is that a seed that germinated. What is that, parsnip? What is this? I keep forgetting. I think last year I forgot. I planted something over here. Y'all know what this is. Totally forgot, and I forgot last year. But anyway, a seed must have germinated here, along with where I had my garlic. And the garlic didn't do too well. I didn't do too well with garlic and strawberries. I'm gonna have to get real gangster when it come down to them strawberries, because them strawberries are real sensitive. And I wanna definitely grow strawberries and harvest and create jams and stuff like that, but I'm just not having no luck. And I know they're very sensitive, so I'm gonna have to treat them things like babies. And I'm gonna work on that. I'm gonna get better at them strawberries. I'm determined to have a harvest like Organic's Best Urban Gardener and Cheryl's Food Forest. I'm determined to get a harvest like that. Okay. So okay, back to the potatoes. Alright, you guys. Okay, I'm on this side now, y'all. Y'all see that? Y'all see those potatoes? Little old Miss Essie. Miss little Miss Essie from Harlem. Okay. More babies. I'm happy with the babies, y'all. One, y'all. on, y'all. Let me get my bucket. Boy, they done rolled all over the place, y'all. Especially these little ones. Y'all bear with me. Babies, I don't even want those ones most. Okay. Okay, some got to that one, so we're gonna let that decompose on down. Not bad, y'all, not bad. That's a good root. Oh, there's another one. One. Oh, I thought I did. All right, you guys, that was not bad at all, and I'm gonna try. I think I'm gonna come back in here if I don't be too tired, because I have to get ready. I have an event later today, and I gotta hit the road, and I might. It won't take too long, so I might get to it. I'm just gonna throw some of them roots in there that look very healthy. Put some worm castings in there and some fertilizer. And I'm gonna see if they produce some more. That's what I'm gonna do. But yeah, you guys, I'm thinking I might have, well, I might have well over 5. I'm sure this is much more than 5 pounds, y'all. It got to be. It got to be. Let's see. They just rolling. I'm going to get these in the house. And I'm going to weigh them. But this is not bad for a first time in a raised bed. This is not bad at all. And I think I planted 3 different kinds. I think it was the red, the purple, and the fingerling potatoes, like these here. That ain't bad, y'all. So Y'all, this is so exciting. I'm very happy with this harvest, y'all. Very happy. So, I'm going to get these in the house. I'm going to weigh them. I'm going to let them sit. They say you got to let them cure. So, I'm not going to bother them. I'm probably just going to cover them up with some paper towel or some newspaper and let them sit for about 2 weeks. And then hopefully get ready, start eating these bad boys. I think some of them you can eat right away. I know, sweet potatoes, you gotta definitely let them cure. You gotta let them cure for 2 weeks or something like that. So I might not even have to do these with the brown potatoes, but I'm thinking with the red potatoes, you're gonna have to let them sit because see, the skin is very delicate and it's already peeling back. So I'm gonna let those sit. I'm probably gonna let all of them sit. But yeah, you guys, I hope y'all enjoyed this harvest video on my potatoes. And thumbs up, like, and subscribe. And like I said, I'm going to try to go through those and get the best rooted ones that look really healthy and just throw them back in with some fertilizer. Just see what happens. Okay, you guys, so this is Essie the Gardener. Thank you for watching my channel. I want to thank all my new subscribers. I hope you guys are enjoying my content. And I'll see you guys on the next video. This is Essie the Gardener. Peace, love, and light. And I'm out.